being explicit about gender equitable teaching practices and using the SciGirls strategies is really important for helping your girls in STEM. The SciGirls strategies are research-based best practices for engaging girls in STEM. We have seen over the years that there is an inequity in the number of women in the STEM fields. Notice the difference between the number of degrees awarded to women in the biological sciences and engineering. There's a real disparity when you look both at the bachelor's degrees and the doctoral degrees over the last decade or so. Our concern grows when we learn that the STEM careers in which women are not advancing are the ones in which demand is growing the most: computer science and engineering. So even though more girls are deciding to major in the sciences and more women are moving into career in tech ed and STEM fields as a whole, these advances are not keeping pace with the rising demand of the work in the field. And it's as women advance through this pipeline into STEM careers, there are all these different places where they can leak out of that pipeline, and even after earning their doctorate is one of those places. So participation and achievement in STEM is pretty equivalent, and yet it's not present at the level of their careers. So 30, 35, 40 years ago, the early work on looking at gender inequities noticed that girls didn't have their hands on the materials in classrooms. They were having lower achievement in science and math. But that's not the case anymore. Today, what we notice is that it's girls' motivation, their attitudes, their interest, and their self-confidence that lag as they age up through the school system. So let's think about what some of the benefits might be of having more women in these careers. Well, first of all, it's job opportunities for women, right? We can't remain competitive in the United States without having more women in our workforce. As we diversify working groups, that increases the effectiveness and capacity of teams moving forward and advancing innovative ideas. And it's meeting the growing demand in these fields. Computer science and engineering fields are growing fast right now. Starting in early adolescence, gender differences begin to appear in girls' interest and confidence in STEM areas. And this grows as they move on into their middle school and high school years. There's a decaying interest in their participation in STEM, and girls are less confident in math and science. Research shows that there is not a difference in the ability for girls to do math and science. The cause for this gender gap is social and cultural, and that's the good news. This is something we can change. Teachers who've taken this training before have said to me, well, a lot of these strategies you're mentioning are just easy and good things to do anyway. So it's not a lot of big changes that you need to make in order to see improvements in your girls in your science and CTE classes. Rather, it's a lot of little things that you're already doing.